Hi everyone, Duke here. Happy Monday, and happy June. I hope your May was as lovely as mine was. Summer's almost here. Or if you're in the Southern Hemisphere, winter's almost here. Sorry for missing an update Thursday and Friday last week. Hopefully the FTL streams have made up for the days I've missed here and there. We are here in Stove Canyon, and we have an approaching wall of lava, which is a great way to start a level. We have 19 lives, which... Oh, crud. Really? Wow, I'm going to have to pick up the pace if I want to make it through that hall. We have 18 lives, which is still pretty good. Most of this game has been spent, you know, on the verge of running out of lives, but we got quite a few extra lives at the end of the last area, which was pretty nice. Uh-oh. Maybe I shouldn't have come down here. I made it out okay. Alright, so there's not going to be any time for chit-chat on this level. I'm going to have to move. Oh my god. Oh. I thought maybe I could bounce my way over that barrier, but that didn't work out. It's kind of a bummer that I lost my rabbit ears, because Wario is much faster when he has that power up. I'm going to have to make good use of the dash move or the charge move to give myself a little bit of extra speed. Can't really slow down to kill these enemies. I should have gone the top route. Okay. Out of my way. Aw, man. There's a key there? I probably shouldn't have stopped for that. That's going to cost me, but... Well, hopefully... I bet the thing that I need the key for is down in the lower half there. I probably missed it. Oh well. Hey! Invincibility. That makes me a little bit faster too, which is nice. I doubt I'm invincible from the approaching lava wall, but it'll make navigating these corridors a little bit easier. Uh-oh. Oh, I can't charge while I'm holding the key. Great. That worked out. I'm probably going to have to forget about that key, because not being able to charge is slowing me down quite a bit, it looks like. On the other hand, you know, if I'm extremely efficient with how I move, I should be able to... Oh, you know what? I should have charged so I could jump on top there instead of taking the bottom route. Oh well. Alright, I'm gonna try this. Well, that did not work out the way I thought it was going to. Well, these 19 lives are starting to rapidly dwindle. And I don't know how you're supposed to go the bottom route if you have the key. Because, I mean, if you drop it to break those blocks, I mean, it's not like you're going to be able to go back for it. So, maybe it's a... Maybe it's an either-or proposition. You can either get the key, or you can go down where all those blocks are. So, I gave myself a little bit more time by taking the top route there. So let's ignore this bottom route. Let's ignore that block and just try to get through this as quickly as possible. Okay, so I can't throw the key, even though there was room, because I was at the top of the screen. Alright, these guys, I can just walk into them if they're not pointing their spears at me. Well, never mind. Not going so hot. Which is ironic, because this is Stove Canyon. You think it would be going extremely hot. Hotly. Alright, if I get down below 10 lives and I haven't hit a checkpoint or anything, I'm just going to forget about the key. Oh no. Okay. Well, I didn't lose too much time going that route. Good. Because as much as I'd like to get the treasure on this level, it might be more trouble than it's worth. This might be one of those instances where I have to come back and worry about the treasure during the bonus stream. I mean, it's shaping up to look like if I do that bonus stream, I'm going to have to do pretty much the whole game over again. Because I want to go back and get the two treasures that I missed. Oh, right. And I want to have to get Treasure C again since I lost that one. Hopefully I don't actually get a game over again. That would be kind of a bummer. Alright, I can make it through here much more easily now. I could have gotten those hearts, but oh well. Alright, so the question is the treasure still... Oh! Well, there it is. Great. Okay, someone in the comments said that I was right about these all being Nintendo references. So I wonder what that one is. Doesn't look like anything Nintendo related. I can't see my treasures on the pause screen or anything, can I? No, I guess not. Maybe it was the orb that Samus gets to transform into an orb. I don't know though. Is that the end? Oh. Well, okay. That level wasn't terrible. You just had to persevere a little bit. Okay. So someone told me how to actually play this game. So I'm gonna give it another shot now that I know what I can do here. You can hold the button and keep your power charged, and you can move left and right with Wario, which should make this about 100 times easier. It would have been nice if it, what? Come on. It would have been nice if it, like, gave you some instructions as to what to do here. Oh no. Well, there's no point in... Alright, I need to not get it at, like, the very tip-top of the meter. I mean, anywhere in the dark area would be fine. At least I assume so. Come on, hurry up. Alright, well, that's better than I've done in this game previously. And I got enough hearts for a 1-up, so I guess it wasn't completely wasted. Well, enough hearts for a 1-up once you add them to what I already had. So yeah, I'm not sure what that orb is. Could be a lot of things. I don't actually remember what that orb in Metroid looks like. All I remember is that it was spherical. So yeah, I've been streaming some FTO lately, which has been a lot of fun. I was a little worried that game would be too difficult for me, but my blind stream, it seemed to go okay. People seemed to enjoy it, watching me kind of figure the game out and narrate my experience of figuring out what to do. Oh. So, by the time this video goes up, I will have done my second FTL stream that happened on Sunday, unless I flaked out on that one, which, if I do flake out, then shame on you, Duke. I'm shaming my future self. Checkpoint here. Guess I might as well go ahead and activate it, even though it's not that far into the level yet. Yeah, FTL's a lot of fun. It's not quite what I was expecting. I was expecting more of like a real-time strategy kind of game. And you can definitely play it that way. But if you play like I did and pause a lot, then it's definitely more of a methodical kind of, I mean, not turn-based, but it's sort of effectively turn-based Of course, it takes a lot longer when you pause as much as I did, but if I didn't pause as often, then the stream would have gone a lot more poorly, I think. But no, it was a lot of fun. At least the first one. The second one could have been a complete disaster, because that hasn't occurred yet as of the time of this recording. I'm going to hope that I can keep my schedule of 5 20 to 30 minute videos a day going. And also do, and it's not worth jumping for that last coin, and do the occasional stream. I'd like to do 5 relatively short videos per week and 1 stream per week. That would be ideal, I think. I'm just going to hang on to my coins. Because, you know, I like making Let's Plays, and I like streaming for different reasons. Like, they're similar experiences, but I don't know. Just having, on the plus side of doing an LP is that it's a lot lower risk. Like, if something goes horribly wrong with this, I can just end this video and start recording from my last save. Of course, it wouldn't be blind, which is the I should have kept my dragon hat. It wouldn't be blind, but it wouldn't be that big of a deal. Whereas with a live stream, if something goes horribly wrong, then, you know, it's there for everyone to see. Everyone can laugh at my failure. But, you know, the feedback and the interaction with the chat room with the live stream is what makes it worth it. I don't know why I thought I could walk through that wall. It looked like a background element to me, but I guess not. Of course, that doesn't stop their swords. I'll hang on to my coins. I think I'm doing okay. I just have to be a little careful around those ducks. So people have been sort of explaining how the whole throwing mechanic in this game works. Apparently, with the large enemies, you can't really kill them by throwing them against walls. You have to throw them into another enemy or into lava. Oh hey, that whole thing is a ladder. That's kind of neat. This whole thing is made out of ladders. Nice. I can probably get those coins now. Well, shows what I know, I guess. I thought if I activated the jetpack while I was on the ladder, that would work, but it doesn't look like that did work. Well, I guess I should have gotten that checkpoint after all. Nah, it's my fault. I shouldn't have been dumb. I should have known that it was the game trying to punish me for my greed, as this game always does. Oh, you can stand on those clouds. I didn't realize that. I guess I have to go this way now. That sucks, I missed out on kind of a lot of coins in there. Oh well. Hey, I said jump, not push. Nope. Man, when Wario picks up an enemy, it prevents you from jumping for like a second. Like, it kind of messes with your momentum. Oh well, I still have 15 lives, that's not horrible. Someone made it sound like this game gets more generous with the coins the more you, the further you get in the game. And I'm hoping it gets more generous with the lives as well. That's what it looks like. Since it gave me all those extra lives at the end of the last level. Hopefully I don't run into another game over. That would be real onion in the ointment, as they say. Or as I said in 1906. I'm glad we're out of the aughts. The 2000 aughts. That was a real awkward time. Alright, do I want to try for those coins again? Probably not. I mean, it's only 6. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, what's 6 coins, you know? As enticing as they are. Yeah, I mean, it was a lot of syllables. I mean, if it was 2006, that's a lot of extra work. I wonder how many hours of work it added to our lives to have to say 2006. I guess it's not that many more syllables. Or some people would say 2006. Alright, B course. Hey! Oh, I guess I don't have 40 coins, do I? I had 40 coins before I entered that door. Alright, let's see if I can actually get all 5 of these. I would consider that a good accomplishment. But yeah, 2014. You know, it just rolls off the tongue better. Why did he throw that so slowly? I don't get it. Maybe your position in the dark part of the meter actually does matter. Yep, it does. Because when the power was all the way at the end, he throws it in like a straight line. You don't really have to lead the enemy at all. Of course, if you try to get that, then you risk. Then you risk mistiming it. Well, 10 hearts. That wasn't worth it. Well, at least I proved my hypothesis incorrect. Alright, well, I guess that'll do it for this video. Tune in tomorrow. It looks like we have at least one or two more levels and then the boss. So that should be an exciting one. See you guys then.